Hey guys, welcome back. So today we got data that new home listings were down almost 45% in April. And at the same time, Zillow is coming out saying they're expecting somewhere between a 2 and 3% decline in home values through 2020. What does that mean for you as a homeowner, as somebody maybe looking to buy, sell, or invest in real estate? That's what we're gonna dive into today. I'm Jeb Smith, I'm a real estate broker here in Southern California. And if you're new to my channel, it's all about real estate. So hit that subscribe button if that interests you at all. And give me a thumbs up if you like that data. So we received data that new home listings were down 45% in April. What does that mean? Is it a surprise? Is that something we expected? You know, where should we go with that information? So, you know, April was the first month that was a full month of stay-at-home orders, of people actually going through the coronavirus epidemic, right? And so, you know, it's no surprise, at least to me, that new home listings during that time were down 45%. Now, keep in mind, most people aren't going to list their home for sale, especially when they're in a stay-at-home order. And a lot of states, like California, for example, for a period of time, we couldn't show owner-occupied properties, right? A lot of states couldn't show properties at all. And so if I were a listing agent and somebody wanted to list their home during that time, and I had this conversation a lot, to me, it was, hey, look, let's hold off and figure out what's going on with the real estate market before we list your house. So to me, a 45% decline in new home listings is not really a surprise. And at the same time, last week we talked about pending home sales for March being down almost 20%. Now, here's what I'm seeing in the last week. So now it's May 5th today, it's Cinco de Mayo, and here's what I've seen in the last week. So this is really the start of March, right? I've had property that was listed at the beginning of April that I've now started to receive offers on, right? These are properties that had very little activity for a period of time that now three of the four listings I'm referring to have multiple offers on them. Okay, so buyer demand has definitely picked up, at least here in Southern California, in a certain price point. Now, these are a lower price point for Southern California. All of these homes are under 700,000, so it's a kind of a different market than the luxury market, right? The luxury market in some cases has slowed down, and that will likely slow, going further. But right now, the lower price point homes are still moving. And so, you know, multiple offers on those properties. I had a property listed last Friday that we already have an offer on. So that tells me that there's activity in the market, right? We've also received data that interest rates, not only will the Fed keep the Fed funds rate near zero, but Fannie Mae has come out and said, we expect that interest rates will drop below 3%. And so, you know, you've got low inventory because new home listings are not up. You've got buyer demand, in my eyes, picking up, at least locally, on the properties that I have. That's what I'm seeing in agents that I'm talking to. And you've got very low interest rates, right? So that tells me that things maybe are starting to normalize a little bit. Now, keep in mind, you still have stay-at-home orders here in California, but you do have some states starting to loosen guidelines, right? So I think, you know, another month of data, or 2 months of data really is the important piece of this puzzle, because, you know, next month's data is going to come out for May, right? And then July's data is going to come out for June. And I think June is when most things will be opened up and back to normal. So July's data is really important because that's going to tell us what's happening with new home listings, what's happening with pending sales, what's happening with mortgage applications. But right now, I'm starting to see real estate pick up a little bit. Now, at the same time, now Zillow came out and said that they're expecting somewhere between a 2 and 3% decline in home values. Well, that to me means very little, right? A 2 or 3% decline in home values doesn't make a big difference to really anything, if you ask me. Now, normally I wouldn't give Zillow a lot of credibility because I think the way they value homes with regards to their Zestimate that they use on their website is garbage. And I've mentioned that in videos before, but they do have a good pulse on the nationwide real estate market with regards to closings, with regards to new listings coming on the market, and they're able to analyze that data. And so they're expecting somewhere between a 2 and 3 decline. Now take this into perspective. If you have a $500,000 property, which is below our average out here in California, but let's use 500 because it's easy to talk about, you know, a 2 or 3% decline in pricing is somewhere between 10 and 15 grand. right? So $15,000, you know, financed, if even if you finance the full 50, you know, because it's going to be less once you put a down payment down, but let's say $15,000, that's going to make very little difference in a mortgage payment every month. So with rates trending lower, likely under 3%, this is not going to stop anybody from buying a house, or it definitely shouldn't. So if you're interested in buying a property, you know, it could be a good time. Now, Zillow at the same time is, while they're expecting a 2-3% decline in home prices, they're also expecting a 50-60% decline in pending in buyer demand. So 50-60% slower in buyer demand. So that again speaks to buyers. If you're a buyer out there, this works in your favor, because now you've got less people looking, interest rates likely trending lower, and only a small decline in home prices. And at the same time, again, they're expecting 2021 for the market to start to rebound. And now, it's not just Zillow saying this. There's economists out there like Lawrence Yun, who's expecting somewhere between a 1-2% increase in home prices even through the end of this year. So there's people expecting home pricing to pick up through the end of this year. Now, real estate was the last to be affected in my eyes, and likely the first out, right? Because, you know, you already start to see people that have been locked in their houses on stay-at-home orders that absolutely hate where they live, right? So these people have been quarantined in a property that they don't like. So these are people out there looking to probably buy a property. You've got people that were thinking about doing something prior to this. And then you've got all of those people that have been told to hold off until the market normalizes, going to start to come back into the market. So you're likely going to see a pickup in inventory as stay-at-home orders loosen. You're going to see a pickup in buyer demand, and you're going to see interest rates likely trend lower, assuming, you know, the mortgage-backed security market and Fannie and Freddie continue to buy loans and put liquidity into the market, which they said they will do. So that means interest rates are going lower. Now, you know, if I were a buyer looking to buy a property, I would still be looking for the right one. If I was a seller, I would continue to talk to an agent, talk about the market, talk about, you know what they would do in order to get your home sold, you know, the competition currently, the current market environment, right? Because each place is going to be different, or each city is going to be different nationwide, because remember, all real estate is local. But locally here in Southern California, we're starting to get some traction back. So, you know, that's my take on where we are at the moment. Again, I'm not predicting some gangbuster real estate market, but I am telling you that real estate is moving. I mean, I'm seeing it myself. I expect it to likely continue. And now, while there may be waves of this epidemic as things open up, and in some cases it might worsen in some areas, again, the fundamentals of the market at the moment remain strong. Even with the unemployment numbers where they are, you know, my guess is the people that are looking are people that weren't affected by that, right? They weren't affected furlough. They weren't affected because they were unemployed. These are people likely looking before this, or people that see light at the end of the tunnel and want to own a property. So anyway, that's my take. I'll continue to update you as I know more on the real estate market and guide you through that process. But if you have questions for me, do me a favor, comment below, reach out to me directly. I'm happy to help. And as always, thank you for your time. We'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.